Well, first of all, congratulations on 100 episodes, right? 100 more?
I don't know if my knees are going to make it, but I'm grooming my son. He's doing very, very well.
Your real life one or Coral?
That's a girl's name, Coral.
Yes.
It does feel like you're getting ready to pass the torch on Michonne, saying, Carl, you know, you're going to be in charge, and you talking about Maggie. Yeah, it feels, I'm a little scared.
Yeah, it's a bit concerning, I have to admit. When I read the script, there are certain things like, this is the end of it, I think I say in the first episode. Ask Scott Gimple. I'm concerned. I'm worried.
I just want to say, as a season 8 premiere, you guys are all aligned, singular in purpose, ready to fight back. Who likes that?
You don't like it? That amount of cheering is exactly what I felt when I was doing the countdown. Just so you know, that even though I am a sheriff's deputy, I am the worst shot ever known. I mean, I'm a disgrace to the Georgia police force. And I'd like to apologize to all of the policemen out there this afternoon and looking after this event. But I'll try harder in episode 2.
The countdown was so great, and I'm wondering if that's the way it was planned, or, I mean, you just look like you had so much fun with that.
Yeah, man, it was such a hard season last season for all of us, all of the people in Alexandria, and, you know, being under this new dictator, and I think that there was a real exuberance to be sort of back with a swagger, with your buddies, and one of the greatest things about this season, all the way through, is that I've been reunited with a lot of the old guard as well. And so we're in spaces with really good mates of mine on screen and off, and I think you're going to enjoy it.
All right, so we have a microphone on each side, and what I'm going to ask you is, I'm sure Mary's done a great job, if you're standing up in the aisle, please, other than the person at the microphone, please step down so everybody can see behind you.
I just want one more thing. So yes, season 7 was so excruciating in a lot of ways, but I feel like that discomfort makes what's happening right now all the more sweeter. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I mean, I've said this already, is that, you know, this is the first, in 100 episodes, it's taken Rick Grimes to come up with a good plan. I think this is it, guys.
Alright, so here's the first one over here to the left.
Hi. Actually, this gentleman wanted to ask a question, so I'm going to help him out first.
Okay.
Andrew, if you could play any other character on the show, who would it be and why?
It would be Negan. Maybe Michonne. This is an emotional moment. I said Michonne and it cut out. Maybe there's something illegal about that. I think I could rock the dreads and the katana. Season 10.
Another new look for Rick, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Character's got to evolve.
I can dread my beard as well. Another hair. Look like every morning for that. Keep it light, Lincoln. It's a family audience. My parents always say, don't swear so much at these events. What's wrong with you? Dragged up? by the way, if you see Norman Reedus today, he got into my car on Friday night late, and he left a little present for me. It was an air freshener in the shape of Daryl Dixon. It was a really hard day, and I'm sort of, you know, I was working very, he had banker's hours, so he left way earlier, and I was like driving back, and I just went, what is that thing, sort of wafting in my face, and it smells kind of right, and I saw a really slim version, remarkably thin version, uber thin version of Norman Reedus. Anyway, next question.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Jennifer from Peachtree City.
Hey, Jennifer from Peachtree City.
You and I talked last year at this panel about our foreign brothers' hats, and you asked if you wanted to trade with me, and I said, I'm sorry I didn't bring it in. So I have the beaver and the cop today, if you're interested.
This is becoming a thing now. People stop me in the street and want my hat. And they try to give me, you know, beavers and cops. Which, so what am I wearing at the moment? I've got the cougar.
I think you got the cougar on, but my husband bought me the beaver.
Okay, what would you like to swap? Oh, should I swap?
Do you like cock or beavers?
Personal photo op with you.
want to know if you have any good recommendations for the book you've read recently.
Do you know, I knew I'd get this question, the book question. I seem to get book questions each year. This has been a really busy year for me. So I haven't really been, I've been too busy learning lines, which is a good thing, because I'm in a lot this year, thankfully. I may not. I've got to get my kung fu kicks together, but I've been in between seasons. I was reading a really interesting book about, it's an interesting book, but it's a rather dull book, about the rise of Islamic State. Don't want to bring the mood down, because we've been talking about beavers and things, but on a more serious note, I'm kind of fascinated by what that is and where it comes from and how we got to the world we are currently in at the moment. And Steve, actually there's a brilliant documentary, Stephen Yeun, remember him? He's been in the 90s. He's my sort of cultural attaché, and he always tips me off about what the kids are down with. But also, because I'm getting a little grey now, but he also said, check out this documentary called Hypernormalization, which is brilliant. And it's, but set aside an afternoon, because it's 3 hours and 45 minutes. But yeah, anyway, so I'm sort of interested in the world and politics and things outside of, you know, show business.